Assalamu alaikum students, your instructor Abdul Rafi here for Statistics 29709 A-Level Mathematics. So this is lecture number 4 and we are discussing chapter number 4 of S2. Now the discussion will be on one of the very important concept of chapter number 4 of sampling and estimation. The discussion we are doing, we started on sampling and estimation and now we have reached confidence interval. So we are going to talk about what is basically confidence interval, the concept related to it, and there are a lot of cases as well. There are three cases, case number 1, 2, and 3. Then there is proportion of the confidence interval as well. So it will be a long series on this. So make sure follow very carefully, understand and revise and practice a lot of questions on confidence interval, because this chapter is 100% tested on the exam. Okay, students, so this chapter is 100% tested on the exam, so of the S2. So what we need to understand, sir, is clear here that we cannot find, we need to understand, students, we cannot find the exact value of the population mean. Okay, so we cannot find the exact value of the population parameter for the mean. Sir, we cannot find the exact value of the population parameter of the mean, and that is why we should find an interval that will be more accurate, and in confidence interval will help us find an estimate for the lower limit and the upper limit. So there are the limits that we can find, and that is why we have confidence interval. This is the formula for confidence interval. That is, we have x bar, the sample mean, okay, where x bar is basically the sample mean, and the z is basically the z value from the statistics table. We multiply it by standard deviation. N is already know that n is the sample size, sir. We are doing square root on it, okay? So that is what we need to understand, students. That is, this is will be the lower limit. What can be the lower mean and what can be the upper mean, the highest value of the mean. So we are finding basically a confidence interval for the population mean, that where can mean lie, okay? Where can mean lie? So that is why we have some percentages here, that is 90%. So you can be asked to find a 90% confidence level. You can be asked to find at 95% confidence level, 97%. And you can be asked to find at 99% as well. Similarly, we have the width as well. The formula for the width is, we might have to find the width of the confidence interval as well, sir. That is 2 times of the z value, that is the statistics value, and times of standard deviation, that is n divided by the square root of n, where n is the sample size, okay? Nx bar is the sample mean. As we already know, these are basically the confidence interval concept number 4. So the first thing we need to understand, that we are talking about, students, case number 1 here. So let me write down the points, the pointers of case number 1 that we should examine, okay, that you should understand and take into account when you are doing confidence interval chapter, okay? So when we talk about case number 1, sir, make sure case number 1 is the same thing, that if we have a normal distribution or not. So case number 1 will say that if the distribution is normal, okay, so the population variable x, so x should be, point number 1 for case number 1 will be that x should be, we can talk about that x variable should be a normal distribution, okay, it should be normally distributed, or it should be normal distribution, that x should be normal distribution, that is case number 1, point number 1. Then the second thing will be that the population variance, because just now we have done, in the previous lecture, we talked about the unbiased estimate of the population mean and variance, students. We talked about unbiased estimate of population mean and variance. We are connecting confidence interval with that. Okay, we cannot find the exact value of population mean, and that is why we are finding an interval for the population mean. So in this case, population variance should be known, sir. So population variance is known. Population variance, that is this thing, is no population variance is known, and the sample size can be of any value. Sample size can be small, large, or can be any size, okay? So sample size can be, sample can be any size, okay, students? So these are the 3 points that you need to understand, that sample can be any size, small or large as well, okay? So these are the 3 factors, 3 things that you have to decide, whether it is case 1, case 2, or case 3. So we have sample can be any size, small or large, okay? So these are the pointers that everyone should know for case number 1. Let me put them in a box as well, so everyone can understand them in detail. So this is case number one, that the variable should be normally distributed, the population variance should be known, and the sample can be of any size, large, small as well. What we need to understand, students, that the z value here we have to find out. So you have to learn with me how to find out this z value, that is what will be the confidence limit and the interval value for the z. Okay, so you can memorize as well for these values, but better to understand logically and then apply in the question. Okay, so we'll have to find the z value, standard deviation, and n will be given. So let's try to attempt with a question and understand this concept with a question, okay? And then we'll work it out in the same way, okay? So here we go. This is a very recent question. Let's talk about, this is basically, sir, concept number four, okay? So sir, this is concept number four on confidence interval, concept number four, and case number one, which is basically on the confidence interval, okay? So as I said, that 90, 95%, 97, and 99% are the common things. So we have a 4-mark question here, students, sir. We have a 4-mark question, 3 marks here and 1 mark here. So we'll try to learn the concept, and as well as we'll be focusing on understanding as well. Because what we need to understand, students, we can comment on the claims. We can comment about the claims on population mean by using confidence interval. So basically, this topic is not about solving only. You must understand the conceptual understanding theory as well to make sure you can answer these type of questions. That is like part two as well. Okay, so we'll be focusing on those as well as soon as the question progresses. Okay, so this is a very recent paper as well. This is May, June 2018. So let's try to calculate. We have to calculate a 95% confidence interval. We have to calculate, sir, a 95% confidence interval for the mu, okay? So we have to calculate the 95% confidence interval for the population mean. As we already have discussed, that this is called a population mean, also called mu in the other language, in the vectors topic, okay? So this is basically, at the moment, we call it population mean, okay? So here we go. Let's talk about it. The management of a factory wishes to find a range with which the time taken. The management of the factory wish to find a range within which the time taken to complete a particular task generally lies. It is given that the time in minutes, they have a normal distribution. So the first tick mark is there. Sir, this is, sir, case number one, because we already have the normal distribution, sir. Case number one applies here. The normal distribution, random sample of 15 employees. The sample size is small, okay, students? The sample size is small. So this is case number one, students, okay? That, sir, sample size is small. Normal distribution and the population mean is not given, but standard deviation is also given, which means the population variance is also known, okay? I'll repeat my point, students. Case, this is why I've chosen case number one example. We are solving a case number one question, and all of the three pointers are matching, that X is normal distribution, the sample size is small, sir, and the population variance is known as well, okay? Next, what we have, the mean time is given, found to be by 52 employees. The mean time taken by these employees found to be 52 minutes, okay, 52 minutes. So let's write it down. The things that, sir, we already know that, let's write it down here, that we already know that X bar is 52. Sir, we know that is the standard deviation will be 6.5, okay, students? And sir, we already know that the sample size will be 15. So what is missing from the formula? That is the Z value that we have to find. So I'm going to apply that as well to tell you how we are going to do it, okay? But let's put in the formula first, because we have to find the 95% confidence interval. So it will be 52 minus the Z value times of 6.5 divided by 15, sir, comma, sorry, square root of 15, because sample size will be square root, okay? This is the formula, right? X bar minus Z multiply by standard deviation divided by square root of the sample size, right, students? Comma, 52 plus the Z value, 52 plus the Z value, that is times of 6.5, again divided by square root 15, because this is what we have to find confidence interval, students, okay? Now, the only thing missing, sir, is basically the confidence interval, the value, that is the Z value. So follow very carefully, students, in a separate understanding, how do you find the confidence interval value? And you can take the help from that for other parts as well, like finding confidence interval Z value for 99%, 90%. So you can find the Z value for any interval if you get this understanding here, okay? So what we are saying when we are saying, what do we mean when we are saying that it is a 95% confidence interval? So students need to understand that this is because it is normally distributed. So we need to understand that, sir, we are saying here that this is the 95% confidence interval area, that the 95% of data lies within the range, okay? That this is basically a normal distribution curve and 95% of the data lies here exactly midpoint, okay? 95% of the data lies here. So what we need to understand, sir, if 95% data lies here, this is our Z value and this is our negative Z value, okay? So we are basically saying that the probability of negative Z value, hope everyone is getting it, probability of negative Z value, is everyone getting this clear? Should be clear on this, okay? The probability from getting the negative Z value to the positive Z value, okay, will be 95% confidence interval, okay? Or let's write it down here only to make in the box, okay? So the probability of negative Z X bar to positive Z X bar is 95% confidence interval, 95% probability, okay, students? We have a 95% confidence probability. So this is lies there. So what we need to understand and judge, sir, is basically this is equal and this value, this percentage is equal. So the probability here is basically, sir, 2.5%. The remaining probability is 5% left. So this is also 2.5 and this is also 2.5, okay, students? So this is also 2.5 and 2.5. So what we need to understand, that we have to find the Z value, students. We'll have to find the Z value for which the probability, we have to find the Z value for which the probability is 0.025, okay? So this is the probability, sir, that 0.025, and we have to find the Z value for this, which will be our confidence interval value at 95%. Hope everyone gets it. That's how you have to do. This is the Z value that is positive. So make sure you go on to the, you will go on to the critical values, and here we go, because we can't find that, right? Everyone knows that you can't find the Z, you can't find the probability for this. So it will be 1 minus 0.025, which will give us, sir, 0.975. This whole area will be, we already know, sir, that this whole area in the red color will be 0.975, and we are trying to find the Z value for this. So you can write it in this way, that probability of Z, we don't know what is it, but we have to find that it is equals to 0.975. So the Z value will be 1.96. Okay, students, the Z value is going to come as 1.96. It's written here 0.975. These are the critical values that are given. That's why I said that the confidence interval will be from somewhat here. So here we go. That is 1.96 is the Z value, sir. Coming back to the question, that, sir, Z value is 1.96. So it will be simple. Just plug in the value there and you will get the answer, sir. 52 minus 1.96. times of 6.5 multiply by 6.5 divided by square root 15, comma 52 plus 1.96 times of 6.5 divided by square root 15, and we will get the answer, students. So let's do it quickly. 52 minus in the bracket 1.96 times of 6.5 divided by square root of 15. So I'm getting this as 48.7. So the lower limit of the population mean will be 48.7, and the upper limit of the population mean will be 52 plus 1.96 and multiply by 6.5 divided by square root of sample size 15. 55.3, sir, this is the answer, that the population mean, there's a 95% chance, students. How do you interpret this? How do you read this? So make sure you understand that. How will you read this and understand this? That there's a 95% chance, the 95% probability, or the confidence interval 95%, we can say that the population mean is going to be between 48.7 and 55.3, okay? The population mean will be between 48.7 and 55.3. I'll repeat my point here, students. at 95% confidence interval, there is a 95% probability chance that the population mean lies between 48.7 and 55.3. You can find out the midpoint as well. Midpoint will be adding the 2 divided by 2, okay? 48.7 plus 55.3 divided by 2, you know how to find the midpoint, okay? What's the main understanding learning should be, students? That you should know how to find the Z value, okay? The Z value is the most critical element that we have learned, okay? So Z value is according to this procedure that you need to know that it is equally split. So if it is 95%, we can say that 2.5% is here, 2.5% is here. And the Z value we found out by using the probability of the less than side as in the case of normal distribution and from the statistics table that we have. Now, couple of understanding important point, make sure to copy this down, take notes as well. We'll be solving more questions on case number 2 and 3. Case number 1 was clear. Later, another 95% confidence interval for the population mean was found based on a random sample of 30 employees. Okay, so students need to understand. Previously, sir, we need to understand, previously the sample was of 15 employees. Now the sample is increased to 30 employees, okay? Now the sample is increased to 30 employees and previously sample was 15 employees. So the same confidence interval is there. So we have to state with the reason. We don't have to find the width, okay? We don't have to find the width here. We'll practice some other question which we have to find the width of the confidence interval. What is the width of confidence interval? We have to tell, state with a reason. We have to tell with a reason for 1 mark whether the width of this confidence interval was less than, equal to, or greater than the width of the previous interval. So without solving the question, you need to understand that if the sample size increases, okay, there is an inverse relation. If the sample size will increase, as we can see from 15 to 30, okay, from 15 to 30, it's simple that the width will become narrower, okay? So width will become narrower, okay, students? So you have to write this, width will become narrower. And what is the reason of it? You can easily understand by the formula. You must have this much knowledge, students. According to the formula, understanding here, follow carefully. It is basically 2 multiply by z multiply by the z value standard deviation divided by square root of n. So if the n is large, it's an inverse relation. Pehle aapka n 15 tha, your first n was 15, so you were getting a different answer. When n will be 30, it will be a smaller answer coming, okay? Because of more information, this will become smaller, okay? So you can write it down that what is going to happen, width will become narrower. And what is the reason for width of becoming narrower? It is the opposite way, because of standard deviation divided by square root n will become smaller, okay? So this will become smaller, this thing will become smaller, this will become smaller as there is more information now, okay? So as there is more information, okay, students? So hope everyone get this. With this, our case number 1 finishes. Confidence interval basic idea should be there, and we'll be discussing more concepts as well. Make sure to follow, subscribe the channel, as well as practice as much questions as possible. Thank you and have a great day. Thank you.